As we've touched upon in earlier episodes, the wizarding community is comprised of witches and wizards from all walks of life, some with magical families, some with a mix, and some finding themselves in the magical minority.
You're a wizard, Harry.
Today, we're focusing on the dynasties of the wizarding world that stem back many generations, complete with their own histories, traditions, and hair colours.
Red hair and a hand-me-down robe? You must be a Weasley.
In the wizarding world, some magical family trees branch all the way back to centuries long ago. And not every magical family is the same. Some, like Draco Malfoy's family, hold some very old-fashioned views on the wizarding world.
What's the use in being a disgrace to the name of wizard if they don't even pay you well for it?
Some, like Harry's family, pass down ancient magical heirlooms. Some have family businesses, or some may even try and hide their past. When you first join Harry and his story, the first wizarding family you'll meet are the Weasleys, who take young Harry under their wing.
Could you tell me how to get onto the platform?
Unlike the Dursleys, who try to hide Harry's magical past, the Weasleys are all about the magic.
It's not much, but it's home.
The Weasleys may not have much money, but they have a lot of heart and a lot of similarities. Take all that red hair, for example, or their general sense of humour.
Yes!
Or the fact that they're all in Gryffindor House.
Gryffindor!
And their home, the Burrow, is steeped in magical family history and curious objects. Part of why it's so crowded all the time. And the Weasleys are a big family.
I think I'd know if Harry Potter was in my house, wouldn't I?
The Weasleys are the perfect example of a classic wizarding family. Ron's siblings grew up knowing what magic was, for a start, learning how to fly on brooms as kids and using magical objects. Something Harry would have to learn the hard way.
Diagonally!
And as they grew up, they'd live traditional wizarding lives.
Just because you're allowed to use magic now does not mean you have to whip your wands out for everything!
And getting traditional wizarding jobs. Arthur Weasley, for example, works at the Ministry of Magic.
And the Misuse of Muggle Artifacts Office.
While Ron's siblings, he has six, range from Hogwarts prefects to dragon handlers.
My parents decided to go to Romania to visit my brother Charlie. He's studying dragons there.
Another great thing about the Weasleys is how accepting they are of Muggle life.
What exactly is the function of a rubber duck?
Some wizarding families, especially ones that go way back, can be less open to the non-magical community. Some wizarding families will even cast out members who befriend Muggles.
And I thought your family could sink no lower.
Indeed, Harry's classmate, Draco Malfoy, has a family that hold ancient traditions. Draco's dad, Lucius Malfoy, works in a very influential position at the Ministry of Magic. And it's much higher up than Arthur Weasley.
My father can afford the best.
Unlike the Weasleys, the Malfoys are an example of a rich wizarding family, complete with resplendent clothes, well-kept hair, and even their own servant, a house elf. And no, they do not treat him very well.
Dobby is bound to serve one family forever.
While the Weasleys come from humble beginnings, with old pets and battered possessions, the Malfoys are used to the finer things in life, with friends in even higher places.
Father and I are in the minister's box. By personal invitation of Cornelius Fudge himself.
In fact, Draco Malfoy comes from a long line of lords and other influential figures. One ancestor was even known to hold court with Queen Elizabeth I. Fun fact, he was also called Lucius Malfoy. And Draco certainly makes sure everyone knows about his family's reputation.
Wait till my father hears about this.
But as you've probably guessed, the Malfoys hold on to more unsavory wizarding sentiments, such as their dislike of Muggles and general judgmental behaviour.
I take absolutely no pleasure being inside your... call this a house?
Sadly, they are a family who have passed down more than just heirlooms and riches. They've passed down a bad attitude. So what about our main hero, Harry's family?
Move!
Well, all right. There was his extended Muggle family, the Dursleys. But Harry had an actual magical family that the Dursleys had lied about having died in a car crash. They actually died at the hands of a dark wizard.
A car crash kill Lily and James Potter? It's a scandal!
Harry actually comes from a long line of witches and wizards on his father's side. He's not even the first Harry Potter. He had an old, noble ancestor known as Harry, who was very outspoken for his time, apparently. And that attitude certainly got passed down.
I think I can tell the wrong sort for myself, thanks.
As for Harry's late parents, Harry is often told he is very much like them, with the eyes of his mother and the Quidditch skills and cheekiness of his father.
You're more like them than you know, Harry.
Of course, we all know families pass down traits and likenesses to their next of kin. The difference with wizards and witches, however, is that they can also inherit magical abilities. There are other things too. As we mentioned earlier, it's quite common for wizarding families to be sorted into the same Hogwarts house. But that might not always be the case, as you will come to discover in Harry Potter and the Cursed Child. Neville Longbottom had parents widely considered as heroes who defended the wizarding world from dark forces. But despite this, lovely Neville took a while to find his own magical groove. And then there's Hermione, well known as the brightest witch of her Hogwarts year, while her parents...
My parents are dentists.
So although the apple doesn't fall far from the tree with certain magical families...
I mean, that was very wrong indeed, boys. Very wrong of you.
You sometimes get surprises.
Ronald Weasley!
And we'll leave some family secrets of the wizarding world for you to discover yourselves.
Wait till you see.
But no matter where you come from or who you're related to, you can be any sort of witch and wizard you want to be. And Hogwarts provides a whole new family for everyone. It's all relative, really. Stay tuned for more episodes of Discover Harry Potter coming soon.